We were asked by the Hong Kong Fintech Week if we could provide not only indoor navigation, but a cool friend finder for a conference that's expected to have 14,000 attendees. It's one of the most prestigious and coolest events in Hong Kong. And the challenge is, how can we set something like this up for an event? Now, there are many ways of doing indoor navigation. You could use hardware beacons, or you could do Wi-Fi fingerprinting, or you could do visual positioning and spatial anchors. But all of these solutions are going to fail because of a couple of constraints that we have. One is a cost constraint. This is just a two-day event, and we can't be dropping tens of thousands of dollars to make a custom solution. The other is a time constraint. The FinTech Week is only running for a few days, and setup is happening the day before, so we have to be able to set up in one day as well. Then there's a data constraint. There's going to be very challenging internet conditions at FinTech Week, as there is on any conference. And things like spatial anchors can be several hundred megabytes, even gigabytes, for the 17,000 square meters that we'll be covering. And this is compounded, of course, by the connectivity issue. We can't build a solution that is reliant on having good internet connection all the time. So what we did is we turned to the post mesh and we decided to use very simple QR-based positioning. This would give us an opportunity to create a digital map of the space that's only a few kilobytes in size. We should be okay even on a poor internet connection and quick to download, but also very, very cheap to set up. So what follows is a little video of us trying to set that up, and let's see how well we did.
So I just spoke to Phil, and the not so good news is that this place is still a mess, and there is no way to set up anything while there's garbage everywhere and boxes and trash.
Yeah, okay, so what do you guys think? We can keep measuring it, like either way we're here all night, but we need to kind of get started.
Set up what we can, as good as we can. And then we just have to like complement with new QR codes as we can.
It looks like somebody's dragged like a ladder or something over it, and it's torn it in the middle. Yeah, we'll inspect them fairly regularly, and then we'll just swap them out if we need to.
The lighthouses. Lighthouses are the QR codes that JB and Phil placed. Here, this will be our origin of our domain. So we have a console that will show, the QR codes that are already reported.
Like, we want to keep the lines straight. We want them to connect to other lines, and we want just everything to be nice and straight. It's OCD. It's our own OCD. But...
So you have to scan every single one here? The entire...
Yes.
Like, one of the reasons that we actually want them to be in a line, because we can more easily look at it in the 3D view on the computer and like see if something is off. So if you know that everything is supposed to be in line, then it's easier to like see if something's... Basically, we did this row up into that. I think when I looked at the map, we're missing some coverage here. I would like the origin to be somewhere around here, like outside here.
How much time do you expect this to take?
I think all day.
All day?
So we have to map out this hall, then there's one more hall that's the same size, right?
Right.
Then we have to draw the nav mesh, like where you can walk, and then place every single booth.
Yeah, super excited.
Super cool.
Yeah. That's the excitement for the big show, right?
Yeah, exactly,
I know.
Yeah. We were here yesterday and we're like, oh my god, it's a construction zone.
Oh yes. So well, this hall, yeah, had 2 days. The other one had only 1 day, so they're still, that's why we still need the jackets.
Yeah, yeah.
But awesome, yeah. I think you would still able to go in the other
side. Yeah,
we're setting up.
How are you doing?
Good, good. Although his is in the cover.
It looks awesome around the
Looks good. Right? Yeah. I think the design, like, it really matches.
It's perfect, yeah.
The design really worked out.
Yeah, so we don't want it cluttered, right? We want it everywhere, but you know, we want people to be able to scan in and like select locations.
Yeah, it's good, but it's not too intrusive.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, fantastic.
How far are you from having scanned the whole thing?
I'm almost done, actually.
Oh, we're going to be another couple of hours. We're just putting the last lighthouses down now. Then we need to do the nav mesh, check that. And then finally, we will place all the booths and the points of interest.
Setting it up was every bit as complicated as we expected. A lot of the booths were not finished until the very last minute. Very happy that we didn't go down the visual positioning route, because of course creating the 3D copy of what the conference looks like is literally not possible until we know what the conference looks like. Even with the QR-based approach, our staff was there until very, very late in the night to set this up. But in the end, it worked out very, very well. Hundreds of people used the navigation. We helped people find the nearest bathroom. We helped people find their friends. We helped people find the right venues. And we managed to set it up in just a couple of hours before the event started. And everything was taken down again when the conference was concluded.
I think the possibility is there for like a really revolutionized like event experience where everybody, like if ever you get lost or your friend sends you a text and says meet me at like whatever booth, you can then scan that QR code and go straight there without ever having to sort of like consider or figure your way out. It would mean that we would spend less time sort of figuring out how to sort of distribute maps to two people and sort of find places to actually sort of display them, because everything would be so accessible and so easy just from QR codes distributed around the location itself. So we would have to be thinking, where are the best places where we can put these QR codes so people actually know A, what to do, and B, sort of how to use them. Dealing with you guys, it's an absolute pleasure. We sent you sort of through the agenda and list of a list of vendors and their locations, and you guys went around and put all the QR codes up. You did all the mapping to the app. You updated the sort of schedule on each of the stages yourselves, and it was a very seamless experience for us. Everybody that has used it has had really good sort of positive feedback, and so yeah, we'd love to have you in the future too.
All in all, I think this was the first time ever anyone attempted to do something like this. We covered 17,000 square meters and we set it up in just a few hours, and we can't wait to try to do it again.
Auki Labs, share your vision.